बिना ना नहीं होता ये सब।
साइड में कहीं भी चाय
अगर हेयर एंड मेकअप ठीक नहीं होता ना तो फिर काम का नहीं है।
यू गाइस आर फैंटास्टिक।
Actually, I mean, like, we've done all this, it's brilliant, and that's expected out of a talent like her. We were struggling for a production design team. When I started off, there was one conversation with the production team, where I said that, kaise hoga? Production always feels thankless, and I know that they get the least acknowledged, but not here. Ek hota hai likhna, ek hota hai dekhna. Aur lighting hai nahi to kya dikhega yaar? You guys have been fantastic. एक बार जोर से साइलेंट बोल। बोलना एक होता है सुनना लगा सुनना पड़ा है बस इतना अच्छा वेल बिहेव्ड टीम। I've told Saurav, I'm only going to work with him. मैं इधर खुला बोलता हूँ।
अरे अपन टीम बना लेते हैं।
Took a lot of time to finally arrive at the sound team. To find smiling faces here. What a team. Thank you. पहली बार फिल्म कर रहे सब बोलते डराते हैं बहुत डरा डराते हैं। We decided that we'll keep the energy positive and alive.
The best.
I just want to say that our journey is not over. We keep the momentum alive and we keep that same spirit alive. A production house की पहचान उसके account से और कोई यहाँ पे किसी ने की complaint नहीं किया मुझे ये नहीं मिले वो नहीं मिला। There's a brilliant team here, film school, non-film school. करके कुछ तो बन गया life में। Brilliant. Between these guys, how they have figured out my madness, I don't know.
It's the best direction team where there's absolutely I've seen no politicking. It's because of you and of course. It all goes back to you, but what a direction team, yeah. Thank you.
Such honesty, man. I've been I mean, he's far kind of experience that he has, and I've been a fan of his work here. I can't thank you. Kitni baar tareef sunega? Okay. Well done and thanks for coming today. Thanks for coming.
Yeah,
today.
I made an okay film, decent film. I don't know. We've just put in our effort, but for anyone who dreams, I dreamt of working with this woman. And I dreamt, it's a 12-year night, and this is the morning, man, she's here.
I screamed actually in the highway saying that my dream has come alive. I wanted to reach here and I still didn't want to. I'm done. I told her, I'm done. I don't care. I don't want to work with anyone. I am done.
I want to work with you.
No, that's okay.
We all are.
Excuse me, second film? Not in India.
Bangladesh.
I want this flower power team to be captured on frame. Everyone in that team should be happening after this, acknowledging everything.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Suresh Triveni. And I tried to impress you with this video. Yeah, are you impressed? Very good. Okay. So, it's an honor, absolute honor to be here. And what I played right now was the day when I finished shooting for my film Tumhari Sulu. That was the last day of my shoot, and that was the first day when my dream came true. They both coincided on the same day. You know, I'm no Christopher Nolan, I'm no Rajkumar Hirani, I'm not one of those, I'm not a very big guy. But with the passion that we make films, okay, this is a small example of it. Okay, what I wanted to, my conversation today would be about how did it all start? What are dreams? And what is this journey called achieving your dream? But mostly, I'll also harper upon the fact the day after your dream comes true. Okay, because that's something which you never dream for. You always dream till a particular day. You don't dream beyond it. And currently, this is nearly a year back, there I'm screaming, I'm done, I'm done, I'm done. And I genuinely felt that I'm done. Honestly, I wanted to make a film. I'm touching 40 in a month's time. You can wish me later. And before that, I wanted to make a film with a talent that I absolutely love and I would love to work with. And I'm done with it. The film did good, got good reviews, and I'm extremely thankful for it. But where did it all start? I'll just come to it very shortly. Okay. I will try to sound a little wise because I'm touching 40. Okay, and intelligent, that's the pressure of age. Okay. But unfortunately, I think a lot of people don't consider the industry that where I come in as intelligent and wise. Yeah, I do make films and I do add films. Okay, that's exactly the place where I come from. So, we've heard beautiful stories about dreams, the inspirational stories, okay, and that's been delved into a lot. I will not delve too much into what were my struggles. I would actually like to give, I'm trying to comprehend this idea. As I talk, I'm actually talking to myself. I'm trying to understand, saying that what all happened in these years and how did I land up here and why am I talking and do I deserve to talk? Okay, those are the questions which I'm trying to answer. I describe myself as a confused Indian. Okay, I'm a Malayali who grew up in Ranchi for 16 years. I studied in Chennai and Delhi, and I'm working in Bombay for the last 14 years. When did I dream of becoming a filmmaker? I have no memory of it. I have absolutely no memory. I clearly remember my dad used to tell me, I think you should join army, not because because he thought that I looked perfect to the part, like I'd look like a good soldier, okay, or I should join a force, like a police force or something like that, because I look like a good soldier or police officer. So if someone asked me, what are dreams, okay, I have tried questioning the basics of it. What are dreams? Dreams are something which it happens when you sleep, right? And mostly the next day morning you don't remember. Correct? Like most of our Hindi films? Okay. So, what is it that, how is it that those dreams you don't remember and certain dreams, you actually take it forward? Okay. And you call them like, I want to be, when did I say that I want to be a filmmaker? If you ask me today how to comprehend dreams, I would say that dreams for me are squatters or refugees or illegal immigrants who come into your mind. Let me throw a little light on that. So imagine your mind is actually, like a big township. There is a mayor, okay, called the reality squad. This township is where you grow up. There's a certain path. There are certain paths which are already laid out there, and then there are these dreams on the fringes. And I imagine them as small, illegal immigrants trying to peep into your head and wanting to convince you, saying that they want a citizenship in that particular town. Okay, at times they're looking for a permanent citizenship. At times they're looking for a working citizen, working visa. For example, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a filmmaker, I want to be an actor, I want to be Elon Musk, okay? They all want to be, they're looking for a work visa. Then there are these resident visa dreams, okay? These squatters, these refugees, they walk in and they try to negotiate, saying that, you know what, I want that house, I want this family, I want this beautiful house with a garden, porch and everything. Most of the times, the personal and the professional squatters, they don't get along with each other. Okay, we're saying that, you know what, first let me finish my agenda, you come a little later. Okay. You're professional, first let me handle my personal. So in my head, I'm going to talk about that this mind is a township. There are these squatters who try to walk in, okay, and they try to negotiate with this reality squad, okay, which is having this big bulldozer, okay, which kind of, when we hear the word crushing the dreams, okay, I think it kind of emanates from there. Okay. So there's this admin section who's given a clear instruction that do not interact with those squatters. They are going to corrupt your brain. Okay, you have already a good township. You don't need them. But then what happens is things that you're kind of prohibited from, you're interested in them more. Okay, these squatters, these dreams lurk in these corners. Okay, and they try to find one entry or the other. Okay, so in my head, cinema for me, I don't know when my influence of cinema was like when I was a kid. Cinema was not looked upon that highly, and especially Hindi cinema. I grew up in a South Indian family, okay, and mostly what used to happen was during Durga Puja celebrations, they used to play these on every night. They used to play these films on a big screen, and my parents were not in sync with the fact that you should go and sit in the ground and watch it and all that. So we used to go to a family friend's house, and through the balcony we used to see these films. But most of the films I've seen it in a reverse order. So when I see a film called Teri Meherbaniya, where the dog runs from left to right, I have seen it running from right to left, and I still believe it. The sounds of those cinema, those elements, okay, stayed with me. And I think one day the bug of cinema as a squatter dream walked into my head and said, convinced me in a certain way, saying that, listen, Suresh, you be a filmmaker. Think about being a filmmaker, because these squatters are excellent hypnotists. They try to convince you. What you speak is at times their words, and that's their skill. The reality, what it does at that particular time is tries to distract you. And how do they distract you? They try to bring in obstacles in your life. Like in my case, I remember that, let me just talk about the first day when I think when the dream spoke to me. It was when Mani Ratnam's film Bombay had released. I remember I went to my tuition teacher. We gave him a fee of 30 bucks and I asked him 10 rupees back because I wanted to watch a film. And I watched this film and I saw a Mani Ratnam film with a red line, and I said, I want to be a filmmaker. I think I like this thought. Anyhow, coming back, so the reality came through. The reality squad came to know that, you know what, Suresh, you're interacting too much with them. Let me distract you. Let me just try to give some obstacles. I was a very good student in 10th, but unfortunately, I flunked in the 12th. Okay. Thereon, their face came between the age of 17 to 24. Okay, where I had multiple struggles, where I had already spoken to my dream, saying that, you know what, I'm coming with you, but the reality was taking me away. So I flunked in 12th. I lost my dad when I was 19. Okay, and then I had to pick up a job which was in sales and marketing. And in fact, I'm a postgraduate diploma in marketing management from Times School of Marketing. So I ended up as a client servicing executive in an advertising agency, which was far from filmmaking. But then one day, I think the squatter dream spoke to me, and it said that, you know what, dude, you're taking me for granted. You spoke to me, but now you're cheating on me. You have 24 hours in a day, right? All of us are 24 hours in a day. Of that, there's discount 7 to 8 hours from there. You're left with 16 or 17 hours. Of that, you're going to work 10 hours a day, or minimum, or at times even at 12, for the next 60 or 40 years. Either cheat on those hours and say that, you know, I will do something that I don't want to, but that's what his reality is telling me, or find a way out. Okay. So I feel that what I'm trying to say is that between reality and dreams, I feel each individual, we always try to, you know, conflict them. We try to bring a conflict between real and dream. How can I ever do this? This is my reality. This is my dream. How do I bring it together? I think, as human beings, we have this fantastic skill of negotiation. And negotiations are one of the most beautiful things that can happen. So it's like this. You at times negotiate to your reality, saying that, you know what, reality, you know what, let me just go there and come back. I'm not leaving you. I'm here. I'm being very real about it. I'm not going to be careless about it. And I speak to my dream and say, you know what, just bear with me for few more days, few more hours, few more years. I'll come back to you. I'm working towards that plan. Negotiate between the two. Very many times we try to deny our reality. But the fact is, we live in a world which is real. And in this world, we try to dream. So there is no way you can escape from the reality. I often tell myself, and how do you do that? Like for me, in retrospective, I mean, this most as I told you, it's a conversation to myself. I think one term that I learned in the last 1 year was a term called allow. Allow things to happen. And when I'm saying not external, I'm saying internal. Allow questioning yourself. Allow accepting reality. Allow negotiating within. Allow opportunities. Allow risks. And don't try to judge it immediately. We try to have a knee-jerk reaction, okay, to everything. And what we try to do is like, we immediately find excuses within our real world, avoiding the dream. Or we go towards the dream, avoiding the real world. I do not have a story of a filmmaker who kind of slept, you know, sleepless or foodless in the streets of Bombay. I was very clear about one thing. I am accountable for my dream. And along with me, there is a world, my family, my friends, and my lifestyle. Okay, I will not compromise on this. Maybe I reached my dream a little later, but I did reach. And one thing I can convince you absolutely, that even when I started joining, so I do ads. I did a very famous ad called Mocha Mocha, which did very well, okay? And I don't attribute the big success to myself. It was the mood of the nation and things happened, okay? And later on, when I started doing the feature, I was doing good in advertising. At the peak of advertising, when I kind of took a sabbatical and made a feature film because I found an opportunity that I wanted to work with Vidya Balan, and I got that. Once I entered that field, again, reality came in saying that, you know what, it's the big bad world of Hindi films, okay? Be very, very careful. And try to give me all skeptic notes about the industry. In fact, I remember in 2016 when the film was greenlit, I was actually a little defensive saying that, you know what, I should, you know, what if this happens, what if that happens? And then I laid back. I said that, you know what, the least you can do is to allow yourself to go through these experiences, okay, and not come to conclusions. What happened eventually was a fact saying that I allowed myself to trust on people. I allowed myself to listen to my team. I allowed myself to make mistakes. I was not hard on myself. And eventually, I ended up on a day like this. And that day was one of the finest days of my life. But it was the most painful day also. Now coming to the facts, saying that what happens after the day you dream? You know what? Nothing changes. I'm not Virat Kohli. It's not like you made a 35th century and the entire world knows. It's a very personal dream that you achieved. You say, yeah, I've done this, but the external world doesn't know. So I walked out from that room, okay, to the real world, and I felt like screaming and shouting, saying that, you know what, I've achieved my dream. But then the world was not bothered. The world was honking. They were going in the same pace. There was no background music to your life, okay? And you're wondering, dude, I've just finished. Then the next day, like I actually felt there was churning happening in my tummy, and I, in my philosophical head, I thought that it's some sort of a metamorphosis that is happening. Okay, but actually nothing was happening, but I slept that day. After a dream, I slept for 12 hours, and I woke up next day, and how much can you tell people that I've achieved my dream? You can't, okay, there's a point they'll also get bored. So what I wanted to tell you was, if you think that achieving a dream is all about it, no, it's just the beginning of it. For me, the day after the dream comes true is the day when you start dreaming again. So do not stop dreaming and accept reality to it. Thanks a lot for your time. Thank you.